Hi everyone, just a quick mention of my book before today's video starts. Watercolour Paper Made Simple by myself, Stephen Cronin. Available on Amazon, hardback, softback, Kindle. So that's on Amazon. Details in the description below. So let me show you today's video. Hi folks, thanks for joining me again. Got a nice little river scene for you today. So before I start painting, let me show you the other colours I've used. So on my palette here, we've got ultramarine, lemon yellow, Payne's grey, alizarin crimson, royal sienna, burnt umber, light red. And the brushes, got the large on Ranson Ake. Little 3/4 inch, I think that is, flat brush. And then the 2 rigger brushes, number 3 rigger, and then the tiny little rigger brush.
I'm going to kick it off with some clear water, just like most of the paintings I do. Now I'm going to take a bit of crimson, a bit of blue, and push that in. Coming in from either side, something like that. And then it's a little bit stronger, a bit more bluey. And then we got just some distant land right far back. A few things growing around there. Very quick dry. Not bone dry, just to stop the paint from coming down the page. Now I want the same colours again, but this time a little bit stronger. Less water, a bit more paint. And coming in. Right now I'm just switching to a little bit of lemon yellow. Blue. That's just the far side of the bank. Clean the brush. I'm going to get back to a sort of raw sienna colour. Straight into that raw sienna there. Something like that. The yellow in there. Bit of ultramarine. The Payne's grey, really dark, and some of the sections. A few little reflections down there. Slightly darker. using a fingernail, just scraping a few little trunks here and there. Clean the brush back to a bit of raw sienna. Just defining where this river goes, something like that. Bit of ultramarine. To darken it in sections. Feathers in front of that. A bigger one in front of that. So it's going to be a little bit darker just to stand out. Let's come down there. Also got a bit of reflection down there. Darken these banks a little bit. Right, and just make sure these papers straight. Oops. I think it's one of those where I'm just going to give it a quick dry, and then I'm just going to wet it all over again, try and get it a bit more atmospheric. And dry, so I'm going to wet, just use clean water with a height brush. I'm just going to brush that all the way down to the bottom. Some of the paint will start to run, but it doesn't matter. And now I'm going to try and create some sort of atmosphere there. Experimenting with it. Let's just see how it works. Just got a little bit of light. Thank you. darker tones in there, darker in there. Use a bigger one. Switching to the rigger brush. Create a few little. I think going on over there in the distance, things growing. Get a foliage on there. Flick that down in the water. As well. Just darken that a little bit. Just get that flat against the board. Pull out little bits here and there, just a little water line. Just pull it across like that. Make the water a little bit more interesting. Right, let's give that a quick turn. I'm going to switch to the bigger brush now. Put some foreground trees in. So, number three rigger. Bit of brown, bit of blue. Put one in there. Same colour again. It's getting a little bit darker. The paint's grey there. I'm really trying to darken it up a little bit. Tweak some things. And then next to that, we've got another one. Put that in as well. There, just flicking it up. These are foreground reeds. I'm sort of flicking between light red and ultramarine. I'll block some sunlight in there as well in a minute. So I want another another big tree on this side, I think. Sort of giving up, about up there, something like that. Just have to keep reloading the brush. I'm just doing brown and blue. Just constantly reloading the brush. Tweaks and things and branches going off all over the place. Over the top. Let's switch back to the height brush. I'm just going to block a bit of landing here in the foreground. So I'm just giving a bit of burnt umber, a bit of ultramarine burnt umber. A bit of light red in there as well. Drawing. These two, they need to be stronger, they're just not standing out enough, so I'm going back to the rigger brush, back into that burnt umber, ultramarine. I'm just going over what I've already done, just to darken it. That's just following it all the way up the trunk. Along some of the twigs and branches. Just blocking the main trunk first. Let's do that again. So I've dried that foreground, these reeds here, so another layer, I'll put it on really dark. See how much darker that is? The light red there, just to change it here and there. Try to pick it up like that with the high brush if you want. So just a bit of variation, slightly, give it a bit of lemon yellow. Just drop a bit of that in, just to vary it, slightly, light there. Just lighten that little bit there. Good job. most of that water out of the ears, and then I'm just going to go a bit of ultramarine, just pushing something to those little light areas. Dry. I'll just put like just a little figure right in the distance. So pretty light in tone. I want to do this. I had sticky wire. That's too light. Still bordering on too light. That's a little bit darker now. I've got to get a new brush. But I can actually add this at almost, I was going to say right angles, but I've had this one for ages. I can't even remember where I got it from. Let's just have a an old man there fishing. Little bird. I'm just going to stick my name down in the corner. So let's stick a mount on this and see what it looks like.
This is the finished painting of the mount, so if we have a closer look. The sky, lighter areas left in the centre, trying to create some sort of light in the water. And then you got sort of purpley, which was alizarin crimson, ultramarine. That's reflected in the distant trees that you can see there along the horizon. Using the same colours as the sky, pushes it right back, and then coming forward a little bit, introduce a bit of lemon yellow, warming up a little bit, and then come further forward still, right up to these river banks. Put them in really dark, reflected in below, and then just use that clean flat brush. Should have took a little bit more out actually, tried to get a bit closer to the white of the paper to create these water lines. You can also use the flat brush just to brush straight across these reflections as well, try and create some sort of ripple effect on the water. See these distant trees put in with the rigger brush, very very weak paints to create that sort of light tone, pushing it right far back, see it reflected as well in the water below. And then in this other bank here, we've got this big tree there, big reflection. So to contrast against some of these lighter tones there, I've put these in really dark. Two or three layers just to get that sort of dark tone in here in the foreground. Just flicked up with the rigger brush here to create these reeds.
and then the rigger again to create this big foreground tree growing right up out of the top of the picture, and then lots of little flicks here and there to create all the little twigs and branches. Painted deliberately very, very light in tone. You see our little fisherman there, just about seen, pick him out there in the distance. So that's it for this one. Hope you enjoyed that. Thanks as always for watching, for your support. Very best of luck with your watercolours. Let me know how you're all getting on. So until next time, keep practicing. And I'll see you all again soon.